In this video, I'm going to be building an improved version of my first generator that can produce more than 30 volts and charge a phone or tablet. For my first generator, I used these tiny fridge magnets, but this time I'm going to be building with a pair of 2.5-inch speaker magnets. Their magnetic field isn't as strong, but it covers a much, much bigger area. I start building the rotor of the generator with two of the speaker magnets clamped to a steel shaft. Before I'm finished, I'm going to install the set screw here to keep the rotor from slipping on the shaft. Next, I'm going to build the coils. One big improvement I'm making over my first generator is that the coils will have ferromagnetic cores, which will dramatically improve their efficiency. This is because the ferromagnetic core basically conducts the magnetic field farther back into the coil, which would normally be farther away from the rotor and produce less voltage otherwise. I create my coils the same way as with the first generator, by just winding them on my drill. So next I print the frame and start assembling it. The frame will hold the rotor, the coils, the gears, the shafts, and pretty much everything that's connected to the generator. This part of the frame holds the rotor shaft, and I'm going to install some ball bearings so that it spins really smoothly. So here I've installed the coils in the frame, and I bolt everything together. Here you can see that those ball bearings really help. If I give this rotor a really good spin, it'll probably go for 5 to 10 seconds because it's so smooth. Next, I fine-tune the gap between the coils and the rotor. I want the coils as close as possible to the rotor so that they generate more voltage when the magnet goes by. Now I'm going to install the drive gear on this notched shaft. The gear has a 10-to-1 ratio, which will allow me to generate way more voltage because the magnet will be spinning 10 times faster than my hand can crank. Now I'm going to build a crank, which will be connected to the gear shaft with a really tight set screw so that it doesn't slip. There's actually no threading inside the base of the crank. The set screw is just oversized, so it stays in really tight. Once the assembly was done, I put the generator on a wooden base and added the charging circuit. I built the phone charging portion from a dollar store USB charger that I pulled out of its casing. Inside there was this chip labeled AD85063. A quick Google search only turned up datasheets in Chinese, but there was enough info in English that I was able to get the numbers I needed. So this will take between 3 and 32 volts and output 5 volts to the USB connector. That's perfect for this application. Being able to charge a phone is pretty cool, but I also wanted to power something flashy, so I made this LED array that I attached to the frame. Before I power everything up, let's take a look at the schematic. It starts over here with the rotor represented as a little magnet symbol, and that spins around the four coils which are wired in series. Those coils then feed a bridge rectifier, which turns the alternating current into direct current, and that voltage is stored in a big bank of capacitors. So those capacitors feed the buck converter chip in the USB charger, and there's also a switch on here that turns on the LED array, which is powered by the capacitor bank. Here's what the finished assembly looks like. I hooked up my multimeter to the capacitor bank and started turning the crank. It was pretty satisfying to see the voltage steadily rise. Cranking at moderate speed, the most I got was around 24 to 25 volts, but if I really sped it up, I was able to get about 32. If we look on an oscilloscope though, the peaks of the alternating current are actually as high as 65 volts. I tested the generator with a bunch of different resistor values as loads and measured the voltage, which you can see here. The best I managed to get was about 500 milliwatts with a 500 ohm load. And while that's not great, considering my first generator only put out about 2 milliwatts, this is about 250 times better. I think my favorite part about this whole project was powering up the rainbow lights in the dark.